Hi, welcome to the Dynamics Tutorials. So one thing that I wanted to go over with you was a quick math review on a topic that's often very confusing to Dynamics students right in the beginning. And it's something that you've seen before in calculus, but you may not have seen this application of it, or you might have seen it very briefly when you had it in calculus. So the idea is, in calculus, you were probably introduced to things like this. So y is a function of x, u is a function of x, y is equal to u squared. And so then you take a derivative of y, you get that y prime, which is dy dx. And that's equal to the derivative of this side, the u squared, so it gives you the 2u. But since it's u and not x, remember that you always had to have that u prime term, or you might have written it as du dx. So we're going to now have to apply that same principle, but now with time derivatives. So let's just take a look at some of it before we get into the kinematics part of dynamics, where we're having to do the math and the dynamics at the same time. So let's look at a couple of functions. So in all of these functions, y is going to be a function of time, and x is going to be a function of time, but y is also going to be a function of x. So we have y is just equal to x, and we're going to do our derivative. So our derivative of y with respect to time is then just the derivative of x with respect to time. And for some reason, oftentimes engineers, instead of writing the dx dt, we just put the variable and we put a single dot over it to indicate that it's a first derivative with respect to time. So just like the dash that you used here in calculus always meant a derivative with respect to x, the dot always means a derivative with respect to time. If we take a second derivative, this would be the second derivative of y with respect to time. We would be taking a derivative then of dx dt, and we'd get the second derivative of x with respect to t. And then we could write that as x double dot. So each dot that you see over the variable is a derivative with respect to time. X single dot dx dt, x double dot d squared x dt squared. Now let's look at some slightly more complicated functions. So we have y is equal to x squared. It's going to be very similar to what we saw up here. We're going to take the derivative of the x squared and get the 2x. But since we're taking a derivative with respect to time, not with respect to x, we wind up having to do the derivative of this variable with respect to time, and this term stays out here. Writing this in the dot notation, it would be 2x times x dot. Then if we're going to take a second derivative, now we have a constant times two variable terms that are multiplied together. So we have to use the product rule. We have the derivative of the first term, which is just going to be a dx dt that we see here, times the existing dx dt that we already had. Then we're going to take a derivative of the second term. So we have the 2x that's set out in front, times the derivative of that second term, which is at d squared x dt squared. And then in the dot notation, you could write this, pulling the 2 out front, 2 times, and then x dot, you've got two of these x dot terms, so x dot squared times plus x times x double dot, close parentheses. And then let's take a look at another function. So here we have y is equal to sine of x. Dy dt is going to give us then, derivative of sine would give us cosine. We're still going to have the derivative of the variable that sits in here with respect to time, so that gives us that dx dt. And then if we pull that term out in front, we get x dot cosine of x. Taking a second derivative, again we have a product of two terms. So derivative of the cosine is going to give us minus sine. It's going to kick out another dx dt. Derivative of the dx dt is going to give us a second derivative of x with respect to time. And then just writing it in this more compact form and pulling the x and derivative terms out front, we'd get x dot squared, because we have two dx dt terms, sine of x with the negative sign in front, plus x double dot, times cosine of x. Thanks for watching!